Hello everyone, this is Rupali Mahanti of Standard 12 Science student from SAI International School. I was really privileged to be on the first Global Immersion Programme to China and I'm really excited to be the host for the next 10-20 minutes on our amazing trip to China. So welcome to this documentary. The long-awaited journey to China finally started on 28th May. We all assembled in the Bhubaneswar airport from where we flew to Kolkata. In Kolkata, we stopped in a mall and had dinner and shopped for a few things. Then we were invited by the Consulate General of China to his private residence to have dinner. Then he taught us how to use chopsticks. Here's a video of how he taught us how to use chopsticks.
First step is have this here. Everyone have it here.
Everyone try.
Put it here and it won't fall. Okay.
Okay.
Good. Very good. And then you hold the second chopstick with your the tip of the thumb and the index finger. So that way
you can pinch.
Yeah. That way it works. Okay. And move it a little bit to the tip of your middle finger. Don't do it here. Okay. Yeah, very good. You're going to make it. Yeah. See?
May 29th, on this day we reached China and we were hosted by our guide Selena and we went to the hotel, took some rest and had our breakfast. Then we went to have our lunch at 12:30 p.m. to an authentic Chinese restaurant. I think had 20 to 30 dishes altogether, and it's a tradition that if someone is first time coming to China, then they have 20 to 30 dishes served to them. After that, we went to the Yunnan Nationalities Park, and where we found out about like 100 of nationalities. My favorite nationality was we tribal people, where we saw their dance, we learned about their culture and food. It was not only the we people, there were like the Mongolian, the Tibet. Every culture and every nationality has something different to story to elaborate, and the park was huge. We shopped for a few time in the Yunnan Nationalities Park, then we came to our hotel and had dinner in a Chinese restaurant. I bought clothes, I bought earrings, I bought so many things. 6:30 a.m. in the morning, and we got dressed up, had our breakfast, and we were on our way to the Stone Forest, which is a 2.5 hours drive from our hotel to the Stone Forest. After we reached Stone Forest, we knew that Stone Forest is a UNESCO heritage site because of its geological background. And here's a clip about the legends of the Stone Forest and the pool of the Yoshima.
This is the Stone Forest. We are standing near the stone of Ashima, the girl who loved a boy. They eloped, but unfortunately the wicked villain captured her. She came to the Stone Forest. She was trapped here. It's just like a maze, so she couldn't get back. Her lover was killed, so she stood here and cried.
And this is our tears.
And they stole.
Huh? And Ashima is...
Ashima was beautiful
as gold.
And show me the stones.
That one, she's standing just in front of the sun.
Okay,
facing towards the left.
This is Ashima and these are her tears.
After the Stone Forest, we went to the Yunnan Museum, where we learnt about the Bronze Age and the symbol of the bull, calf and the cow. And here's a clipping.
This is a figure of a cow, mother cow, and a baby cow is down. And the tiger, he wants to actually eat the baby cow. And the mother loves her child so much that she is protecting her baby. And so there's a great fight between the tiger and the cow. But so here, they are telling us that this is very powerful and the tiger at the back is very powerful. But in the middle, we have a calf to balance both of them. And this was really made 2000 years ago. This is a really nice concept.
On 31st of May, we packed our bags, our costumes and everything what we needed for our presentation and left for Kunming No. 8 High School. On the gate, we were hosted by 20 of students and their teachers and greeted well. Then we changed our costumes and represented our presentation. In our presentation, we presented 7 different states: Odisha, Punjab, Assam, Gujarat, West Bengal and Mumbai. I personally represented Odisha. After that, we went for a science class, following the calligraphy class, the painting class, and last but not the least, the football class. In the calligraphy class, We learnt about writing our names in Chinese, and we also wrote our name in Chinese and in English. Here's a clipping of what we did in our calligraphy class and what we wrote.
So now we are here in calligraphy class, and Mitsa is helping us write our names in Chinese calligraphy, and we are copying it. Seems to be awesome.
What have you learned so far? Which characters?
We learned how to write China and India.
How do you say it? India.
Indo.
Into.
Very good.
On 1st of June, we woke up in the morning, had our breakfast and checked out of the hotel, got onto our buses and went to the airport so to leave to Fuzhou. And the day went traveling all alone. After we reached Fuzhou, we were hosted by our new tour guide Nana and James, the foreign officer of Fuzhou. We went on the bus, then we went to a lake, a beautiful lake by the side of the city. Fuzhou is known for its lakes and rivers. After that, we went to have lunch. We ate octopus, smashed potatoes, crabs, lobster, rice, chicken, everything. Then, my least favorite thing was octopus. For the first time, I tried octopus and I liked it not that much. On June 2nd, we went to the Fuzhou Language School and we again presented the same presentation what we presented in the Kunming No. 8 High School. Then our school signed the MOU with the first Fuzhou Province Language School, where we will have mutual visits to the different countries. After that, we went to the physics lab, learned little physics. I don't like it because I find it boring, but still, I enjoyed it. After our physics class, we were interviewed by a Chinese, local Chinese news channel, and here's a clipping of that.
印度赛伊国际学校的师生代表团一行昨天来到福州外国语学校进行访问交流，开展教学合作。印度赛伊国际学校和福州外国语学校在福州签署了合作备忘录。 未来三年，双方将搭建教育教学网络交流平台，促进两校学生在线交流，并互派师生开展短期交流学习。
SAI国际学校作为一个英语实力很强的学校，欢迎我们老师和同学们都过去印度参加交流。而且他听说我们这边有模拟联合国，也希望在未来三年他们的模拟联合国计划和我们学校的模拟联合国社团都有更好的交流。
拥有5000多名学生的赛伊国际学校在印度排名第5，课程设置多样化，教学理念先进。福州外国语学校历史悠久，注重外语教学，双方合作有助于培养具有国际视野的优秀人才。两校还互赠礼物，并表演了各自的特色节目。就是听了他们讲以后，我就是
对这个非常有兴趣，然后也是很想就说去印度那边去看一下这些风土人情，很想去参与进去。到这边来学习中文，还有我们这边的教育方式可能跟他印度那边也比较不一样，他也很想去体验一下这方面，还有就是参与一些那种课外活动。
On June 2nd, we went to a World Heritage Site, 3 lanes and 7 alleys. It is a place where they preserve the different homes of ancient people, and it is actually well preserved. Many Chinese leaders are from these 3 lanes and 7 alleys. It is a wonderful place to shop also. We did a lot of shopping there. So there was like stamps made out carved out of stones on your names, and silk scarves and combs made of yak bones. After we had done shopping in 3 lanes and 7 alleys, we boarded our bus, then went to the airport where we boarded our flight to Beijing, and the trip ended in Fuzhou. On June 4th, after having breakfast, we first went to the Tiananmen Square and the Forbidden City. On our way to Tiananmen Square and Forbidden City, we found a city wall which was 600 years old. After reaching Forbidden City, we saw a huge place where the Chinese Revolution in 1949 took place. Actually, Tiananmen Square can hold millions of people and at the same time. Forbidden City is a huge palace and it is a home to many of the dynasties of the China. It also had an imperial garden which is very beautiful. Its beauty cannot be defined in words. It took a very long time from starting of the Forbidden City to the end gate. It took us like 3 hours to complete the whole palace. Now you can imagine how big it was. On the fifth June, we went to the seventh wonder of the world, the Great Wall of China. It was my second wonder of the world because I first visited Taj Mahal in Delhi, which is in India. We were so much excited about the trip. When we first arrived at the Great Wall of China, I was literally awestruck because I never thought it will be so huge. There were two wings, one was north wing and the other one was south wing. We were 8 people in our group, so we splitted. 4 went to the north wing and 4 went with the south wing. I was in the north wing with my teachers. There were so many towers that we couldn't climb, but I reached till the 4th tower. It took me like 2 hours to climb the 4 towers.
Finally, we have reached the 4th one, 4th fort of the Great Wall of China.
How long have we been climbing?
We even did not expect that. And the scenic beauty,
45 minutes.
It took us really 45 minutes. And the scenic beauty of this Great Wall of China is beyond our imagination. No one can even imagine it.
Say hi. Well done, Rupali.
It was a breathless journey.
Rangavati, 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 Kona Kalata, Asinati Kalapata.
On 6th June, we packed our bags, left the hotel, and boarded our flight to India. It was really sad that I was leaving China, but it was a memorable journey. And I won't forget it in my entire life. And I'll really miss the people I met there. I think their style of having food, using chopsticks, and their way of maintaining things, their cleanliness, and everything. Everything was different than India. The infrastructure was amazing, and the city was clean. Everything was very well managed, even the traffic. When I was in China, I visited Kunming, Fuzhou, and Beijing. My favorite UNESCO heritage site was Stone Forest because I got to click a lot of beautiful pictures. We met 2 groups which hosted us, and I think everyone was friendly. They were a little surprised because we were totally different from theirs, and they learned little English, but we were stronger because English is our first language in India. So both of the groups were equally amazing. I visited enjoying Kunming No. 8 High School because they actually hosted us, but in Fuzhou language school, they had classes, so we didn't much time to spend with the students. I think Chinese people stayed together. They had equal respect for everyone in their culture, and I just loved everything about their culture. The whole family stayed together in one house, and they participated in various functions, celebrations, everything. Yeah, there were many similarities between India and China, except the food and the clothing. Then rest, everything is same. No, I didn't get a chance to find out about the family structure, but China has a like well-organized family planning thing, so which we were asked about by Mr. Ma. So I would like to end this video with tears in my eyes, and I think you have enjoyed the video as much as I enjoyed the trip to China and 1,000 miles back to India. This is Rupali Mahanti from SAI International School signing off. I am wishing you safe travels on all your ventures.